Okay, well, hello. It's been a long time. I wanted to do a review of one of this book. I've been getting a lot of emails as well, and I always was procrastinating to do this book review. This book is, a lot of you have asked me questions about it as well, and I have used this for the last 4 years. And this book, I call it as the textbook for LTE or the handbook. And when I use this word, I don't use it just for the marketing purpose, I use it in real sense. In 2012, that was a smaller edition in black and white version. And this one is a bigger second edition, comes in a bigger size. There are four reasons I'm going to mention here about this specific book. And after that, if you decide that you want to have the source of information for you, if you are working in LTE domain, feel free to get it from Amazon or get it from your library as well. Number one reason is, in case if you are working in telecommunications and you want to have a textbook about 3GPP standards related to LTE. Not any other textbook in the market which talks about a lot of details. In case if you want to the point information, this book is the best source, because as the title is LTE in bullets, so the author Chris Johnson, he has written other books on WCDMA as well. He has reviewed each particular chapter or written each chapter based on the crux or the meat of each of 3GPP standard documentation. So when you go in any chapter, you won't find paragraphs, you will find bullets or line by line information. So if you want to know about handover, it is not going to talk about the details of handovers. The details will be there. However, you are going to find information related to, I may say, line by line, so that if you want a specific information, that will be available. Number two is, this book is very lean. And when I say this book is lean in terms of information, so it cuts down all the extra information and goes to the point. So each line or each bullet you read, that gives you information to the point as well. So in case if you know about technology, about 4G LTE, and you are looking for specific information in the standard, let's say, then what you can do is you can just find that particular information in this book, and it will tell you whatever the standards say about it. So the book is not directly focused on any specific vendor technology. It's focused specifically on 3GPP standardization. Number three, which I would mention, is that this specific book has 32 different chapters. Each chapter goes into enough details as well. In case if you don't know about a certain topic, what 3GPP standards say about that specific topic, then this specific book will give you those 3GPP standard references as well at the end. So whatever topic you see at the end, there always will be 3GPP references included, so that you can find more information in detail as well. As I said, that this book has been only focused on the specific to the point details which you need if you have information. In case if you want to look at the standards itself, you can just look at the references which are given at the end of each paragraph or each section. Number four and final reason which I have is, in case if you are in LTE and want to remain in telecommunication, keep this as your handbook. Keep it on your desk. Wherever I have gone, people who are especially designers or work specifically in domain of LTE, they keep it as a reference book, because it gives you exact to the point information and definition as well. Having said that, in case if you don't want to buy this, that's fine. It's usually available in public libraries as well. If it's not available, you can request this from your local library as well. In fact, what happened to my book, the one, my copy is a colored one. I used it so much, then it's not readable anymore, meaning the book is torn apart. I used it, yeah. I make notes and stuff on it, so it wasn't enough in a condition to carry it in a book format. So I got it from a local public library here at university, and highly recommended. Other than that, I think I wouldn't go into specific chapters what each chapter covers. You can find this information in the book. You go on Amazon, you will see the contents of the book as well. One final thing I will say, if I have to start learning about LTE from scratch, I would definitely keep this specific book as my number one choice, number one. Number two reason I will give in terms of is, even if I know about technology, this will still remain a reference book, because the way the author has bulletized each and every information, that is much more convenient. The approach is really, really professional. When I say really, really professional, at least it helps me to understand things much more easily and conveniently as well. And I expect that you will also find this a lot more beneficial. So that was my review for this book, LTE in Bullets. Go get your copy now. Thank you.